Annyeong!
Welcome to Delightful! In my last tutorial, we took a thorough look at how to make a sewn doll wig. I won't be going into as much detail this time around, so I recommend watching the first video before this one. For this project, you'll need a measuring tape, scrap paper, normal tape, needle and thread, pins, stretchy fabric, elastic, and synthetic doll hair, which you can buy from dollyhair.com or restoredoll.com. And of course, your animal-eared doll. I'm using Hyuju's Freya from junkiespot.com. To begin, we have to turn that loose hair into wefts. I thoroughly demonstrate how to do this in the previous video. Tape down, sew, flip, sew again, remove the tape, and tear away the paper. There are variables like how tightly you sew your rows of hair together or how tall the doll's head is, but in general, I've devised this equation to determine how many lengths of wefts you'll need. In other words, you'll need 5.3 times the length of the head circumference, if I did the math right. Now it's time to make the wig cap. Measure the circumference of your doll's head around where you want the hairline to be, and subtract half a centimeter to a centimeter. This will be your elastic length. We take a little off the full length measurement because we want our elastic to stretch tight over the head. Sew the ends together and set it aside. Now take your stretchy fabric and wrap it over the doll's head, ears and all. Rubber band it in place. Now take a sharp pair of scissors and make small incisions at the tips of the ears. As the fabric scooches down over the ears, continue cutting and stretching the fabric until it's laying right against the head. Because the fabric is stretchy, it's forgiving. Don't worry if the edges are a little choppy right now, just leave it. Make sure it's tightly rubber banded in place again before moving on to the next step. Take your elastic loop you just made and stretch it over the head. I position the sewn area in the back as a marker for orientation, although in this case the ear holes should make it obvious enough. Nonetheless, a good habit to practice. Taking the thread and needle, sew the elastic band to the lace cap. I use an alternating topside downside whip stitch. The ears kind of get in the way, so if you have a curved needle, I suggest using it. Might make the job easier. Once you've made it all the way around, remove the rubber band and trim the excess lace. It's time to strengthen the ear holes we cut earlier. Taking tacky glue, I'm going to fold back the excess fabric we left on and stick it down to itself. I'm using tacky glue because it's meant for fabric and is water resistant, meaning it will survive the boil washing stage later. That's looking pretty good, but even so, I want to make sure the ear holes don't deform. Taking another tidbit of my lace, I'm going to glue on some reinforcements. I'm not too worried about getting glue on the doll's head, in case you're wondering. It'll peel right off the plastic later. That looks nice and sturdy. Once it's fully dry, remove the wig cap from the doll.
It looks like a pair of underwear.
Take the panties, flip it inside out, and put it back on the doll. Should look like this. Time to finally start adding the hair. The first few wefts are attached the same way as a normal sewn wig. In other words, around the outer hairline. Pin the weft in place first, then hand stitch it to the cap. I add a touch of glue to the wefts after I stitch them in place. It's just an added measure to keep the hair from falling out. If you've got any loose threads, now's your chance to tighten them up while you sew. Next, I'm going around that thin strip below the ear, making sure I cover up all the lace. If you remember from our first tutorial, we sew in a continuous spiral around the head until we reach the crown. Well, not in this case, the ears are in our way. So instead, I'm laying down horizontal strips of wefts and working my way up the back of the head. When it comes to handling this area next to the ears, fold the weft over so that the edge looks clean. Keep on sewing until you work your way up to the top. I've had a couple people ask if you can use yarn for these kinds of wigs. I think you can use whatever you want as long as you can sew it into a weft. I've also had people ask if this method works for a human-sized wig. I've never tried it on that scale, but I feel like it would totally work. I mean, you'd have to use a bigger elastic, but yeah. If anyone has made a life-size wig using this method, please let us know in the comments. I'm a bit curious myself. Once you're finally near the crown of the head, you may have the space to sew in a spiral again. If you have a particularly thick weft of hair, the top of the head is where you want to use it. I want to position a thick weft at the top of the ears so that the hair falls around the ear and hides the imperfections of the wig. You're almost done! The last step is filling in that funny bald spot on the top of your doll's head. Here's how to do that. Take one last weft and slowly spiral it together, sewing it to itself. I'm adding a little glue for extra strength. You want a spiral that's a perfect match to the bald spot in size. Now we want to sew the spiral into the hole. To do this, I remove the wig from the doll and flip it back and forth, working my way all the way around the last weft. Once you've gone around, add a few stitches in the center for strength. Put the wig back on. It should look a little crazy like this. Find the center of the spiral weft best you can and evenly disperse the hair. To get the hair to lay down, you can either use a blow dryer on a low setting or boil wash the hair. I'm going to boil wash it because I don't own a hair dryer. In the previous video, I showed you how to make a nice part for this style of sewn wig. I'm going to employ that same technique not only on her part, but above the ears as well, to hide the base of the wefts from view. You may notice a big problem area. That's right, under the ear. Depending on your doll's ear orientation, you may not even be able to see this area. For example, if the ear was rotated a little and facing more upward, the hair would fall over and cover this spot. If it does show, you can always style the doll's hair to hide it. Otherwise, I'm gonna cheat a little bit. I'm going to make two quick, simple, flat glue wefts of hair using Fabri-Tac glue again. Once they're dry, I'm going to add some more glue onto my problem area and pop the extra wefts on top, concealing what's beneath. Not quite as elegant a solution as I would have liked, but it did the job. All that's left now is to cut and style your wig. For helpful styling and cutting guides, check out Denise Medrano and Jaylantis Toys channels. And voila, your wig is all done! Thank you for joining me, and I hope you found the information and techniques in this video useful for when you make your own wigs. Like and subscribe to see more videos about doll customizing, and I'll see you next time! Stay artsy! Annyeong!